affected by this society, this world, being condemned is actually cool. Now, today we hear the gospel from St. Mark about his father bringing his boy to Christ. And as you heard in the gospel, he suffers with that new spirit. And most likely this father went to all kinds of doctors, but he's approaching Christ and says, please help this boy. Now, think about it. How many times do we rely on Christ like that? How many times do we actually say, as it says in that beautiful prayer of Sinner from the Syrian, Lord and Master of my life? You heard that first sentence. Lord and Master of my life. First of all, that we are able to admit that He is my Lord and He's the Master of my life. Spare me from the spirit of indifference, despair, lust for power, and idle chatter. Literally asking our Lord and Master of my life to save me from that spirit of indifference, the spirit of apathy and despair, the spirit of despair, the lack of faith, lust for power. This world is so hungry for power. Look around. How many times do we say, spare me from this spirit of lust for power? Or spare me from that spiritual state, for me being hungry for power, and idle chatter? Lord, save me from that. How many times do we say that? How many times do we approach Christ with this request? And then the second or middle part of the prayer says, instead, grant him the spirit of integrity, humility, patience, and love. It's very hard in these days to be a man of integrity, a person of humility, of patience, not with others, but with myself, and love. And it's approaching Christ and saying, help me to do those things. So I don't rely on this world, but I want to rely on you. When we were baptized, many of us most likely don't remember that time that we had sponsors, we had godparents. And the whole idea is actually that we're being brought up in faith and help each other growing up in faith. And St. Gregory the theologian, he's talking about that spiritual state that happens to us in baptism. And we're supposed to nurture those states. I'll read a few of these. By baptism, what happens to us? The illumination of souls. A change of how you live. Help for our weakness. Resignation of the flesh. Obedience to the Spirit. Communion with the Word. Correcting the image. The disappearance of sin. Participating in light, the destruction of darkness, the vehicle to God, society with Christ, sustenance for faith, the perfection of intelligence, the key to the kingdom, deliverance from bonds, everything that is honorable. constant combat. Do we maintain even that state, that spiritual state? And what do we do for that? You know, I'll tell you a little, very simple example. When the bees are being born, they have to go through a process of trying to get out of that cell. The process is so important that it makes that bee struggle like never before, but that struggle makes those juices in the bee to come alive and all the muscles to start moving. If that struggle doesn't happen, let's say that we feel sorry for that bee and we want to help that bee because it's suffering, and we come and make a teeny tiny cut in that brood comb or that membrane of that cell so that bee can actually get out easily. You know what happens? That bee will die. Because it doesn't go through the process of struggling, making the muscles stronger and those juices start moving, and by making that cut, that shortcut for the bee, being designed by God, it's gonna make the bee a die. That's what's happening in our spirituality as well. If we're not struggling and anything we're looking for is a shortcut in our lives, we're going to be spiritually dead. If we only rely on this world, we're going to die in this spiritual state of ours. We need Christ so bad. Not only us here, we need to pray for others as well. I tell you what, you don't have to go far away. If you weren't here during the week in this school, you wouldn't be surprised how many children are actually being affected by those evil powers. How many of them have lack of love? How many of them are literally shaking during the day? As I'm looking for kids walking from high school coming across here, you're thinking, like, how can someone like this walk on earth? A lack of love. A lack of God. No identity. And we're asking Christ, not only for us, but for those children and those people, that spare them from that spirit and give them the spirit, the Holy Spirit, that gives life again. So ask for ourselves, but ask for others. Help each other to be there in good spiritual state, the state that we got in the baptism. But we need to nurture the spiritual state. Baptism is very important. But we need to live that baptism every single day of our lives. And struggle. But remember that the struggle, spiritual struggle, will